Hello, welcome back. In our last video, we discussed about the issued Selenium IDE. Okay, so essentially the IDE is not capable to have looping statement, conditional role structure, and so on. Okay, and that is the basic drawback of the IDE. Just to recall what IDE does, it just basically runs as a Firefox plugin, and this is your Firefox browser, and it is going to give this Selenium commands like open this URL. So it will open the Firefox and it will go to this website. Then it will click on this button and then wait. So this is what the second command does. Okay. So basically this IDE is good for that, but it doesn't have capability to change the parameter dynamically. I cannot really run with different sets of parameters. Essentially, IDE does not have any programming interface. However, to do those kind of things, Selenium supports two things. One is Selenium remote control server, and second one is Selenium web driver. So in this video, we are going to mostly discuss about Selenium remote control server and how the architecture of Selenium remote control server and what kind of things it can do and what kind of things it cannot do. Okay. So recall that IDE is just a plugin and it automates the browser. Similarly, what we can do, we can have some kind of program called a client. Let's say this is our client. So this client is going to send Selenium commands to a server, and that server is called Selenium Remote Control Server, or simply let's call that one RC. And this Selenium Remote Control Server consists of some JavaScript library which is called Selenium Core. All right, so that is called Selenium Core. So Selenium Core is basically some JavaScript function. And whenever the client is going to say open this URL, the client is going to send a command, and that command is say open, and it is going to send with open some parameter, and that parameter is urbis.com. Also, the client is going to say that which browser is going to open. Then the Selenium RC is going to open that browser, and let's say that browser is Firefox browser. And then what it's going to do, it's going to inject the Selenium core, that means the JavaScript functions, to this Firefox browser. We are going to have Selenium core JavaScript libraries here in the Firefox browser. Then the client is going to send this command called click and wait. Okay. So the application under test right now is that, okay, it must have sent this open URL. Therefore, we have already urbis.com is loaded here in this browser. And within that browser, we have already have Selenium core JavaScript available. Then client is going to say, click and wait. Okay. So this is one more request. Okay. Click and wait. And then the Selenium server is going to understand that I'm going to give it to the Selenium core to execute that. And Selenium core is going to execute that one on this browser. Next, whatever the response of that one is going to send to the Selenium remote control, and then that thing is going to send to the client. Okay, so this is what you're seeing, a architectural diagram of remote control server, where this remote control server is written in Java, and this is just a proxy between the client and the Firefox. The client is nothing but something similar to IDE giving these commands. And this client is just basically a programming language which is basically giving these Selenium commands to the remote control server. So that means any language that can basically send bunch of commands to the Selenium server will be a client. And this can be implemented in multiple languages like Java, Perl, PHP, Python, Ruby, and so on. So whenever I'm saying a Selenium core with Java, Selenium remote control with Java binding, that means I'm writing my client program in Java programming language. Okay, so this is a Java program, and that Java program is basically sending all these bunch of commands one after another. And this Selenium remote control server is understanding those commands and giving it to the Selenium core, which is a JavaScript functions to execute those things. So essentially, since this can be written in a programming languages like Java, therefore it can use all the programming capability like control structure, like storing the variable. Remember, we are storing the prices here in this thing in a parameter in the IDE. But here, you can create an array and store those things. And we can also create an array to store different data type parameters like origin city, destination city, origin date and destination date. Sorry, starting date and leaving date. And we can do a for loop. And for loop, we can execute these set of commands multiple times. Okay, so as you see, that's going to solve my first issue that I faced in IDE, that I got a full-fledged programming capabilities. So here is another thing. This remote control server and this Firefox browser or Internet Explorer browser will run on one machine. Okay, so this is a physical boundary. All these things are going to run on one machine. This client can be on another machine, or this client can be here in the same machine. So we are going to give you an example using Java binding, how these things really works out. So here is the pretty picture, and this has been taken from the Selenium documentation, and that is here. So you can also go on and check it out. That's in Selenium remote control. Let me explain you the same thing that whatever I told in this picture. This is the client, and this client can be written in programming language of your choice. But in this course, we are going to use Java. Then we have the remote control server. It is a program written in Java. And then the first time it starts a browser, it would inject the Selenium core, and Selenium core is basically bundled with the Selenium with the remote control server. Okay, and this Selenium core is same on every browser. Okay, so whenever you're going to start a Firefox browser, it's going to inject that Selenium core to the Firefox browser, and then whatever the Selenium commands are going to come, so these commands are going to go to the Selenium control server. And then that is going to forward it to the Selenium core to execute those things, and whatever is get response back and back to this thing. And this is what you are doing here. This is called the remote control server. So this is a part of Selenium 1.0. Right now we are in 2.0. So essentially, this does not really handle a couple of things very nicely. For example, you have an AJAX page where a region of the page is refreshed. In that case, we have to do some kind of workaround using remote control server to work that one out. Therefore, they come up with another nice way to do this thing. That is, in Selenium 2.0, they introduced another toolset, which is going to do a similar thing whatever remote control server was doing. And that is called WebDriver. And WebDriver is a part of 2.0. So essentially, if you are going to start a new project, then maybe you need to do using WebDriver. That is the best way. And in this course, we are going to give a lot of emphasis on WebDriver. Even though we're just going to show a very basic Selenium 1.0 or remote control server example, but most of the time, we're going to focus on the web driver. Okay. I hope you get my point on the Selenium 1.0 and remote control server. Thank you.